Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Lands of Lore. In today's episode, we are hopefully going to finally get into the Urbish mines. However, before we do that, we have some of these guys to finish killing. And last episode, they were beating the hell out of us pretty good. So hopefully that isn't going to last into this episode, because they're most likely guarding something that we need. I think I just cornered myself. Alright, I think that should be all of them, I hope. Looking like it.
This stump has been picked clean.
Some ginseng.
No one tends these woods.
Let's see whereabouts we are here. Alright. Just kinda out wandering. Oh god. No more!
Empty.
Damn.
Locked.
I don't have enough magic.
Shut up, Conrad. A cane leather jerkin. Ooh, lightning.
Empty.
Okay, and I doubt this is going to... Well, there you go. Barada got some better armor. I suppose that counts for something. And we'll get Conrad here back to throwing his throwing star. Actually, scratch that. We'll get Conrad back to his crossbow. I don't even know why I have that thing. I think this is the right way? No, it is not. We want to go this way.
Empty.
Another basil ring.
Empty. There are silver. Empty. Empty.
Oh god. No more. Please, no more. Yeah, I was gonna say, I don't suppose either of us have enough magic to actually cast the lightning spell. Lightning's actually fairly powerful. Not as powerful as Conrad's crossbow. Ouch! Dang. Get him back up. Man, these things are hammering on us. Why can't they just leave me alone? Oh my god. Come on. Come fight instead of just standing there and shooting your stupid cr- Oh, we're out of range. Oh, no we're not. Damn it. Bakata, you need your heals. Jesus. Man, blowing so much healing on these stupid things.
Empty.
Oh wow, we made some pretty good progress. And I freaking thought there was a secret down here. Is there anyone else? Or is it just a time saver? Just a time saver. I was gonna say, yeah, I thought we were near Dawn's camp. but I don't think we'll be able to talk to her.
Good day, sir. Have you seen a woman by the name of Dawn?
Or was I to know what I'd be telling the likes of ya?
We're from Gladstone, and I have an urgent need to speak with Dawn.
With the treachery of Scotia, I'd not trust me own mother without proof 'twas really her.
Alright. And I don't know if this will get us anywhere.
I don't care if you're buying or selling. I ain't interested.
Alright, in that case, I don't believe we have any proof. We do not. Okay.
Get on with thee now and stop ya bothering me.
Yeah, she's just in the back of the wagon. But, I think once we get the third party member into our group, we'll be able to, talk to her. But until then, we got some stuff to do. Notably, we've got to get into the damn Urbish mines and get past the thing that guards them. I think it's called like a Larkon or something. And then it's mean, and I don't want to fight it.
Empty.
I don't want to fight it without a specific item.
This stump has been picked clean.
Swarm. Alright, what do we got here?
Spare this poor traveler a few coins.
Alright, now, if you don't give him any money, you don't get something later in the game. Well, you can, but you have to pay for it, so we're going to give him some coins.
Thank you, sir. You are very kind.
I'm glad to be of service.
There. Now, what that'll do is, later in the game, we'll get a magic cloak for free, as opposed to having to pay a crap ton of money for it.
Empty.
And I managed to go the wrong way. And we want to go this way. Oh god. Ha! That's what we were looking for! Convenient! And this skull is what will let us kill the guardian of the Urbish Mines without taking 45 minutes. And I'd show you what it does, but I don't want to waste any charges, because we'll be needing probably all of them. Okay, and what do we have here? A long sword. I've already been there, I think. And there's nothing down here. Alright, to the mines! And we are sleeping, because this place is gonna be mean. Alright. And we're gonna save. And this is the Larkon.
I suppose there could be another entrance, but this one may not work.
I don't shut have up, enough magic.
And its whole thing is, as you can see, it disarms you.
I don't
you.
Have enough magic.
Shut up, Conrad. Murder. Oh, crap. No. We want the skull.
I don't have.
Ah. Yeah, you can sit back there. We're in no rush. Pro tip, don't sleep with the thing loose. Okay.
Do you suppose there could be another entrance? That this one may not work.
I don't have enough magic.
God damn it.
I don't have enough magic.
Alright, Bakata, say whatever you're gonna friggin' say and screw us over.
Do you suppose there could be another entrance? That this one may not work.
Alright. And basically, I'm going to show you how you're more or less expected to kill this stupid damn thing. We really shouldn't have come to this entrance. Alright. So basically, you go in and you hit it with the skull, then you come out and you sleep. And then you go back in and you hit it with the skull again, then you come out and sleep. And this would normally take 45 minutes, because if you don't have the skull, if you don't have the skull, you sit here and you throw items at it.
I don't have enough magic.
And it takes forever. That's how I used to kill it when I was younger, because I didn't know about the skull, but now I do, and we can lay waste to things. And as you can see, it has damage states. This thing gets pretty pretty ripped up looking towards the end. We can actually probably hit it with like spark or freeze from Conrad too when we get in there. I don't know if it's susceptible to freeze. Nope. But as you can see, it's pretty poor looking right now. Love this music. And that should kill it. Or not. Lightning! Okay. The electric, it does nothing. And yes, this is like... this is really the only boss monster I can remember in this game outside of Scotia at the very end. There we go. Alright, get everybody their crap back. Let's see, now how did I have these on here? Eh, doesn't matter. Alright, and we will rest again before we go down. And now we have the green skull. I don't remember how many charges it has, so I'm not going to be spamming it. Okay. And nope, no mana for lightning. Alas, I was going to show it to you guys too. And there are these there things down here. These weird creatures. Which, if I remember correctly, they're susceptible. If I remember correctly, they're susceptible to spark. And we can loot all kinds of stuff from these drawers.
Nope. No, they appear to have left in a hurry.
Anything? Nope. And that they're giving
most
you a ton of.
To have left in a hurry.
That they're giving you a ton of oil flasks is kind of a portent of things to come.
Or the history of a mine. More orc jargon, no doubt. Warning, wear your helmet.
Think this goes down? Yes. Okay, that can stay closed for the time being.
All wages paid in silver crowns.
There's silver coins in here.
Sickness is no excuse. Thaumgogs do not get double pay.
That's what Bakata is. He's a Thaumgog.
They appear to have left in a hurry.
Ooh. We're just getting all kinds of death magic in here. Good stuff. Alright, move this stuff down here. Snag that. There. Look. And of course, no mana for the fireball either. Boo, the door she does not open.
Notice. Only one meal per day. No exceptions for dwarves. They appear to have left in a hurry.
How can you say that? Like, how do you know that they left in a hurry? It's just a freaking table. Damn it. Come on, Conrad, hit fourth level rogue already. I want to give you weapons again.
Tool inventories.
Another set of lockpicks.
Monthly quota sheets. Notes, papers. Nothing of interest to us.
Man, these things got some hit points on them. Alright. Electrocution it is. Let's see, how many spell points does he have? Only 18. A helm.
Or...
nothing.
This is already unlocked.
Haha! Alright, we can't do anything with that yet. It's a pumping mechanism.
Most of these files are used.
Yeah.
Notes, paper. Most.
Haha. More oil! Even with all this oil, I can guarantee you we'll be spending a portion of this dungeon running around in the dark. Because this place is huge. This is probably my least favorite area in the game. Thankfully, you only have to go through it once, and it's early, so... ooh, some more salve. More oil. We're gonna leave some stuff here, I think. We will leave it. Where will we leave it? Not there. I think these are the stairs down.
Warning, where's
yes.
Your helmet?
And we'll keep the sledge because we might need it, and the riddle scroll can stay too. Who dares snip at Conrad's behind? None of that. That's not where we were. We were in here. There. Now we'll come down here. Let's see, I think there's a secret in one of these rooms.
Notes, paper.
Where'd you even come from?
No.
Back to looting. Yay! More salve. Leave some lockpicks here, too. Because I think we only need one set. And I'm leaving this damn horseshoe. Now...
tool inventories.
I think... maybe it's not this wall. Now... because there's a secret, like, little compartment room in here that we want to check out. Let's see what we've seen already. Okay, I think I see what we missed. It's in here. There we go. And there's a guy back here. Lantern is nearly full. And we'll scare the crap out of this guy in just a second. Boo.
At last! You must be the rescue party.
We could kill him!
What happened to the miners?
They all ran away last year when monsters invaded the mine. I alone stayed behind to finish the monthly tool inventory. How did you get in? One of those hideous Larcons has been blocking the only passage.
We seek a friend who may be in these mines. Have you seen anyone come past here?
I've been hiding under the desk and eating nothing but these stale biscuits for months. There could be a herd of wild horses down on one of the lower levels and I wouldn't know about it. All I want to do is to get out of here.
The Larcon at the entrance is now dead. You may make your escape now.
Excellent. I'll leave as soon as I finish these reports.
Alright, and there's some goodies we can get in here like
You'll
this.
You'll need that if you go messing around in the mines.
See, I think we can also take the pick.
I'll find that out to you right away.
And I want to say that's it.
There's a big hole in that bucket. You miners are required to bring your own lamps. I join you, but I need to get out of here.
Yeah, okay. So now we have a pick and a great helm, which is worth a whopping 7 points of armor. I will give it to Bacata. Simply because... Damn it.
I knew you would...
No! Leave me alone, you small, creepy-looking person. Alright. Oh god. Now, I think we can dig with the pick in addition to the sledge, so we're gonna leave the sledge, I think. Because... Yeah, this thing's terrible. Okay. Really, the only thing we should be keeping is probably this sword, because when the third party member joins us, I believe he comes with his own equipment, but that rapier is actually pretty decent. Alright, and before we go down, I'm saving. And actually, go back in there. Yes, it looks like we do have multiple saves, so that's good. And I think this is where we'll start bumping into things that eat our armor. Those will eat your armor, I believe. Ah, but I do not remember. Damn it. This is not a place to be. Eat bees! There's like a dead miner in here somewhere, and I believe he has the key on him that we need to proceed deeper into the mines. Note.
Warren, it is true I tell you. The rocks are alive. I am leaving this accursed place. Jeff.
The rocks are alive, actually, and that's where we get one of our... Oh yeah, the little things. That's where we get one of our, riddle things, the heart of the beast that never lived. It's already starting to get dark. Now, I know there's something we need in here. We might have to mine to get it, though. Could probably try picking that lock too. Save having to look around. No, switch to cut.
There's no way to pick this lock.
Bah. Alrighty. We'll poke around a little bit more. Where's that pick at? Damn it. Oh, I know the stupid thing's back here somewhere. Can't bash the door, of course. And I doubt we already have the stupid thing, because I do not recall picking it up. Excuse me. No. And I hear those stupid things giggling in here. Keeping an eye on the ground in case it's laying somewhere and I've just missed it. Which could very well be the case. As our lantern slowly runs out of oil. Ah! Get out of here. Come on, Conrad. Level that rogue already. Okay, this is... darn. This is starting to frustrate me. Alright, we have like a whopping 4 minutes left in this episode, so what I think I'm going to do is save it here and call it quits for now, and in the interim between now and next episode, I will find this dang thing, and we will continue on with our exploration of the Urbish mines. However, until then, I'm going to call this an episode, so I will see you folks later.